Hello all, welcome to IQ Pop. Today I will discuss about for loop. So there is three kind of loop: for loop, while loop and do while loop. So usually we use loops for doing same task repeatedly for a finite number of times. So I am using the word finite because loop must iterate for finite numbers of time. If it is undefined, that number of time is undefined, then it will become an infinite loop and it will never stop. And it may stop based on the memory capability of your computer. Mainly here memory means that say there is a counter for your loop, say I++. You are using some, I'll show you that one. And what is the range of integers? It is say 32 bits, so up to 2 to the power 32 times it can iterate. Okay, so let's go for the next slide. So here is the flowchart initialization statement. So here we initialize, here you can see I equal to 0, so that is the initialization statement. You can say see here next test expression. So then we check that whether some expression, provided expression, is going to be satisfied or not. So here you can see I less than 10, it is going to satisfy. Next, if it is true, then body of the loop is going to be executed. So if I less than 10, then body of loop, whatever we will write here as body, that will be executed. Then it will update the statement. So here I++ is the update statement. So I++ will be updated, and again it will go for test expression. So it will test expression again. If it becomes true, that means the test result is true, then it is again going to execute the for loop, body of the loop. If it is passed, it will exit the loop and it will encounter the next statement what is there after the loop at this place. Okay, so let's go for, okay, so let's write a program with using for loop. So for that I need to declare a variable first, say int I, which will be used as a counter in the for loop. So for I equal to 0, first step is initialize. Next step, we want to iterate the loop for 10 times. So I less than 10, so starting from 0 to 9 is less than 10, so it is going to be executed for 10 times. Next is update. So let's do I++. Next, now say we want to print hello IQ pop for 10 times. Now let's execute the code and let's see what is the output is coming here. You can see hello IQ pop, it is printed for 10 times. If you give a new line here, then it will be depicted very clearly. So do it. Yeah. So it is printing 10 times hello IQ pop. Now say if you want to print 1 to 10, then you can see here this I is it varying from 0 to 9. When I is going to be 10, that loop is going to be break. So let's see what are the value of I in each iteration. Okay, so how can we do that? Simply write %d, new line is okay, display I. Alright, now it will print the value of I in each iteration. Okay, and it will go to the new line. So let's do it. Now you can see it is printing 0 to 9. So, okay, so in the first iteration it is 0, and in last iteration it is 9, and the next time when I becoming 10 less than 10, this condition becoming failure and that loop stops. So if somebody wants to print 1 to 10 using this, so we can do simply I plus 1. So what will happen? Now you can see it is printing 1 to 10. Okay, so lots of things we can do here. We can square of number up to 1 to 10. If you want to print, so you can simply do I plus 1, sorry, and this side also. Now it will show you square of numbers from starting from 1 to 10. So 1 square is 1, 2 square 4, 3 square 9, 4 square 16. So like this it is showing you. Okay, now what other thing we can do? Yes, see, I have not shown the body of the loop here, right, for the one statement. Now what happens if I have multiple statement? So printf, okay, this thing is okay, but in the same time we want to print say ith iteration. So we are writing %d iteration, right? So %d here is going to carry the value of I, so it will be starting from 0 to 9. So in this case what is going to happen, you can see here. Okay, see, ith iteration, see, finally it is showing only one time, but I want to display this thing ith iteration every time. In every iteration it should print. Okay, so for that thing, why it is happening? First, it is happening due to these two statements are there and we have a for loop here, and as you have not declared or defined the body of for loop, what is the body of for loop? By default, the C compiler taking only one statement as a body of for loop. But if we declare define the body like this, starting from here to here is the body of the for loop, then you can see the change here. Okay, 1, then 0th iteration it is printing. Okay, so see, first it is printing 1 square, then 1. Next it is printing 0th iteration, a 0th iteration. Next it is printing 1th iteration. Then it is, see, 4 here, 9 here. So as we have not given new lines, so this is coming in a single line. So if you put a new line, that thing will be solved. So it will look good now. Yeah. Okay. So I should give this new line before this one. Now it is okay? Yeah, it is okay. So okay, so we have seen what is the body of the for loop, and if there is no body also, then what is going to happen? If I am going to remove the body, now execute, see, there is no error. Okay, so there may be a for loop without a body. So okay, now can you declare a variable here? Say instead of if we don't want to declare I here, I want to declare I here itself, and also initialize I here itself. So will it work? Let's see. Yeah, it is working. So we can declare a variable inside for loop itself. Next, say we have here outside this for loop j also. Can we initialize two variable here? Let's say j equal to say 2. Sorry. Can you do this? Yes, we can do this. There is no error, right? It is not affecting the thing at all. So we can do this. Next, if we want to update the value of j also here, j plus equal to 2. So the value of j is incrementing by 2 and we want to display value of j every time. Alright. So here we can write here j equal to. Okay. Now see the output. See. So there is no error at all. First thing, next thing, it is showing the value of j and it is incrementing and changing the value, right? So we can update numbers of variables inside for loop in the syntax itself. Now, can you write some complex statement here? Say I less than 10. At the same time, you want to check whether and j less than say 15. Okay, so both the things must be satisfied, then only the loop is going to be iterated. Now see what happens. Yes, see, when j become 14, the loop is terminated. Even it is showing the sixth iteration, right? So you can see here it is sixth iteration, j equal to 14, the loop is terminated. Next, what we can do, we can use nested loop also. Say we want to display the multiplication table of 1 to 10. Okay, so keep j here. I don't need this part for the time being. I need to deploy a nested for loop. So for loop is here. I'm creating another for loop inside it. And I am going to do multiplication table from 1 to 10. So for I, it is going to iterate 10 times, and for each value of I, the inner for loop will iterate for another 10 times, which will be counted by this j. So I am making j less than equal to 10 and j plus plus. Okay, now we need to print here the value of j. Printf, sorry, percent d, comma, j, semicolon. So it will print the value of j, give some space so that it will print space also. And once one line is done, then we need to give a new line here. So write printf, double quote, slash n. If you are having any doubt, I am giving this a new line here. You can just remove it and try it. What is happening now? You can see here it is showing what. Okay, so I have not multiplied, right? So here, instead of printing j, I should do what? I into j. Yeah. And so I need to give some space here, right? So now you can see it is printing the multiplication table. Okay, 9 into 9, 8 to 1. So anything you can check here. Okay, so this is the nested for loop. Okay, another thing we can do, that is break the loop based on some condition. Say here we want to break the loop if say I into j greater than, not greater than, say less than 54, okay, then break. So what will happen when it will find that I into j is, sorry, make it greater than, is greater than 54, it will break the loop and it will stop the program. So you can see here. Okay, you can see it, the loop is broken. It has taken only one value which is greater than 54, and that is due to, you know, first it is printing the value, then it is doing this thing, checking the code. So if you do the reverse thing here, that problem will be solved. Yeah, okay. Now you will not find anything greater than 54. Okay, so maximum value you can find here, that is 54. When it is encountering some value 54, it is breaking the inner loop and it is going in the out. Thank you for watching. Like, comment, share and subscribe.